Well, it is the final sprint for Queensland's vaccine campaign. Residents who want to be fully protected when the state reopens on December the 17th have just days left to get their first shot.
Yeah, there are immunisation pop-ups across the state, including at Brisbane Showgrounds, which is where we find the CEO of Caravan in Queensland, who is hoping stragglers will roll up their sleeves this weekend. We're also joined by infectious diseases expert Dr. Paul Griffin. Good morning, guys. Thank you for your time. First to you, Doctor. Should Queensland be opening up, do you think, if they don't hit that 80% target?
Look, I think we still do have to open up. What's clear is we can't rely on all these really harsh mitigation strategies forever. I'm confident we can get to that 80% rate, and we know what's coming after we do open up is entirely dependent on that vaccination rate. So we definitely need to aim for 80 and keep going and try and get it as high as we can.
But it's around 63% at the moment. I mean, you've got a long way to go, right?
Oh, absolutely. It's clear we're nowhere near where we need to be able to open up safely. But that's why we need to do everything we can, like we're hearing about today, to get that rate up, get the vaccine to as many people as we can who haven't had a chance to yet, and make sure we support that increase in access by good communication to make sure everyone knows why it's so important.
Paul, Premier Palaszczuk singled out 16 regions that are still well behind in their vaccination rates. Why are they lagging?
Look, I think there's many factors. I think some of those areas haven't seen many cases and so think they're relatively protected, so have a low perception of risk and so haven't sought out the vaccine. I think access in some of those locations has been an issue also. But again, I think the communication hasn't necessarily been tailored to some of those populations, so the right messages have hit home. And they're the things we need to address. I think the access has improved greatly in the last few days and weeks, but we do need to get that communication right, that messaging right, so everyone across the state, or in fact the country, knows how important it is to be protected when we open up.
Mm. Anastasia Palaszczuk has warned that once the border does open, a tsunami of cases will follow. Do you think we're going to see that?
Look, I think we have to be careful with how we describe, what's coming. We want to make sure people understand there will be cases, and if our vaccination rate isn't high enough, then there'll be high consequences of this virus spreading across our state and our country. But we don't want to be too alarmist, because then I think people are a bit sceptical or maybe lose engagement. So, as I say, we know the cases are coming. We're in a very fortunate position to be able to be prepared before that happens, and we need to make sure we take the opportunity to do that as much as we can.
Took a bit of an outbreak in Sydney to get things rolling, but it did, didn't it? Jason, you're at the Caravan and Outdoor Show where there's a pop-up COVID vaccination hub. Are you expecting to see plenty of people rolling up their sleeves today?
Yeah, we are. Today and Sunday are going to be our busiest days, and we've had a lot of interest from consumers who have already got their tickets coming to the show, who are hopefully ready to roll up their sleeves and get that vaccination on site as well.
So how will it work?
So we've set up a clinic in conjunction with Queensland Health in one of the buildings here. It's very simple. It's very similar to one of the pop-up clinics that you'll see around the state this weekend as well. You simply register, have a little bit of a consult, and then you'll sit down with one of the nurses and they'll go through the vaccination, and then they'll assess you for 15 minutes afterwards, and away you go, ready to travel through the show and hopefully select a recreational vehicle.
So, well, there you go. Tourism has been hit hard by the pandemic, but the caravanning industry is thriving. Everyone's looking forward to hitting the road, huh?
Yeah, they are. We've had an immense surge in interest and retail activity since midway through last year, and it has shown no signs of slowing while international borders remain closed. And the attendance this weekend is anything to go by. There's still so much interest, and it's really good for domestic tourism.
For people who are thinking about doing a road trip once borders open, what have you got on display there?
Oh, look, we've got everything from glamping tents right through to $500,000 motorhomes. So there's really something on offer for every budget, every taste.
Very good. Well, I'm sure you're going to be busy today, and it's great to see a pop-up clinic there as well. Thank you both for coming on the show. We appreciate it, as always.